Question 34, Electronics and Communication Engineering, GATE 2016 Set 1. In the circuit shown below, the maximum power transferred to the resistor R is dash what? This is a numerical answer type question, and for a detailed lecture on this concept, please refer the NPTEL video, Maximum Power Transfer Theorem by Dr. Nagendra Krishnapura, Department of Electrical Engineering, IIT Madras. Let's have a look at this theorem and then solve this problem. The theorem states that the maximum amount of power will be dissipated by a load resistance when that load resistance is equal to the Thevenin resistance of the network supplying power. Therefore, in this network, when R is equal to the Thevenin resistance of this network, maximum power will be transferred to it. First, let us find out the value of this resistance and hence find out the maximum power. The maximum power is given by VTH whole square divided by 4 times RL. Now, for maximum power transfer, RL should be equal to RTH, only then maximum power will be transferred to the load. And VTH is the Thevenin voltage considered from the ends of the load terminal when the load is open circuited. So from this perspective, the voltage that appears across these two points is the Thevenin equivalent voltage VTH. First, let us find the Thevenin equivalent voltage VTH. So this voltage is the voltage that appears across the 40 kilo ohm resistor. To find out this voltage, we need to find out the voltage that appears across 40 kilo ohm. And for this, we need to find out the value of 100 V naught. So to find out 100 V naught, we have to first find out the value of V naught. So let's work on the left loop first. We can apply KVL to the first loop. Let us consider this current to be I naught. So therefore, we will be getting 5 is equal to 3k I naught plus 2k into I naught. So this implies that I naught is equal to 5 volt divided by 5 kilo ohm, which is equal to 1 milliampere. Therefore, the value of V naught is equal to 1 milliampere into 2 kilo ohm, which is equal to 2 volt. This is a dependent source. So 100 V naught is equal to 2 into 100, 200 volt. So this 200 volt is shared by two resistors, 10 kilo ohm and 40 kilo ohm. Because both of them are in series, voltage division takes place. By voltage division rule, the voltage across the 40 kilo ohm resistor is given by the supplied voltage 200 times 40 divided by 50. Both are in kilo ohms, so this will cancel. This will be equal to 160 volt. Therefore, the Thevenin equivalent voltage is equal to 160 volt. Now, we have to find out the value of Thevenin equivalent resistance. The value of Thevenin equivalent resistance is the resistance of the network from this perspective when we remove the load. This is RTH. In this circuit, we have a dependent source, so we cannot directly short circuit this voltage source to find out RTH. So for that, let us short circuit the output terminals, and the current through this short is the short circuit current. The resistance RTH can be found by dividing the Thevenin equivalent voltage and the short circuit current. Let's find out the short circuit current first. The current that passes through the shorted path of the load terminal is short circuit current. Under this setup, the current that is supplied by this voltage goes through the 10 kilo ohm resistor and it directly jumps into the short, ignoring this 40 kilo ohm. Therefore, the short circuit current will be 100 V naught divided by 10 kilo ohm, which is equal to 200 volt divided by 10 kilo ohm, which is 20 milliampere. The short circuit current is 20 milliampere. And we have already found out the value of VTH to be 160 volt. Therefore, the value of RTH is equal to 160 160 volt divided by 20 milliampere, which is equal to 8 kilo ohm. We are asked to find out the maximum power transferred to the load, which is Thevenin voltage square divided by 4 times the Thevenin equivalent resistance. This is 160 into 160 divided by 4 into 8 into 10 to the power 3. This is equal to 800 into 10 power minus 3. The maximum power is 0.8 watt. We are asked to find out the maximum power in watt. Therefore, this is 0.8 watt. Thank you.